I want to show everybody how fast the virus can spread by contact and how important it is to wash your hands and be very aware of what you touch, especially before touching your face, your mouth, your eyes, or your food. The way I'm going to set this up is pretend that I'm sick and I just sneezed into my hand. Then I'm going to grab the doorknob, open the door, and enter the garage area. But I'm going to be using a non-toxic UV dye in place of the spray that would have been in my hand. Then I'm just going to start my work day. And this is a pretty realistic scenario if somebody was sick, and I've seen it happen so many times where they sneeze and then grab the doorknob, somebody else comes right behind them. Today we're working as a smaller crew. It's just going to be me and the two girls I work with. I told them that all we're doing today is picking up some shots for this turbo diesel engine and this full gauge project, and that's pretty much it. They have no knowledge of what's going on. I'm gonna let them show up, just start their daily routine, work about 4 hours up until lunchtime. Then I'm gonna tell them what I'm up to. We're gonna pull out the cameras and the UV light and go around the entire compound and see just how far this is spread in a 4 hour time period amongst three people. Let's see what happens. Let the test begin. It's been 4 hours, time for the black light. Now this is how my compound is laid out. We have multiple areas and multiple floors. Everything is separated by doors. So there's doorknobs, handles, everywhere. And the bathroom is in a different building altogether. I'll be starting out in the garage with our assistant camera girl's hands. As clean as she thought her hands were, turned out that this stuff got everywhere. On the palms of her hands, on the back of her hands, on the front of the slate, on the back of the slate, on the erasable marker, and even on the pen. Now on to the cell phone, which nobody's supposed to be using, but these things happen. There's contamination on the power button and the charging port underneath. Now on to the camera department, which I must say was pretty clean overall. There was mostly contamination just on the camera and a couple other areas like the battery bags, the lens bag, and the production bag, but that was about it. And the last thing in the garage I want to look at is my cup that I use for water. The fact that my cup lit up like a Christmas tree isn't surprising to me because this stuff was all over my hands. Next, we're going to move on into the buildings, which are all the doorknobs and the bathroom area in the studio. As you can see, it's all over that doorknob. That's the second door. This is the third exterior door. And as you can see, it's all over the handle there. Not too bad on the numbers, so maybe they left the door open a couple times, but it's all over that handle. It's all over the door jamb. So that's probably where they grabbed the door to close the door. And then it's all over the interior where they grabbed the door to open the door when they're exiting. Those are pretty much all of the entrance doors. Next up is the bathroom. The first thing we're gonna take a look at in here are the switches, which is the first thing that everybody touches when they come into the bathroom, even though the light is automatic. Let's take a look at the light switches. Light switches are super contaminated. So the next person that comes in here is definitely, getting sick. Then we're gonna look at the sink. First thing I wanna see is the faucet handles. I mean, the whole faucet looks overall pretty clean, except for that spot on the cold water right there. So I'm guessing that somebody used the cold water to wash their hands. Next, the toilet. And there's a spot right there where somebody opened the lid. There's a hot spot there. And also I'm guessing where they go to flush the toilet, just that little button. There you go, bam. Right there. And the last thing I want to see in the bathroom is the last thing everybody grabs, which is the handle to get out of the bathroom, not to get in the bathroom. To get in the bathroom, you just have to push on the exterior, but you have to grab the handle to get out. Well, there you go. If that was a virus, it would have spread everywhere that somebody would normally touch in a matter of 4 hours amongst three people. Give it more time and more people, and it would have traveled even further. All it takes is for somebody to come along, touch one of those surfaces, and then touch their eyes, nose, or mouth, and more than likely they're getting sick. Now you can get a really good idea for why proper and frequent hand washing is so important, as well as paying attention to the items that you touch and what you touch after you wash your hands to keep your hands clean. I hope this video helps you avoid getting sick by giving you a good example of how viruses and germs spread by contact so quickly and so thoroughly. And if you have a friend of yours who doesn't believe in frequent and proper hand washing, be sure to share this video with them and show them why they're wrong. Hopefully I gave you something to think about that's going to help you. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Share your opinion, hit that like button, and I'll see you next time. As you can see, it's all over the radio as well.